Would you look at that? The ruin that Stemmer mentioned. There should be another ornament inside. Another ornament. Gotta find a way to get to it. A lot of water in here. Might be part of the same water system as Moreland's ruins. Like there's a drain beyond that grate in the wall. This crate could come in handy. Don't find green shine too often. Thank you. This crate looks like it can block the drain. Water's flowing towards the drain in the wall. There. Water's pouring out of that busted pipe. Water's flowing towards the drain in the wall. Whoa. Water's rising fast. Key module. Gently. Door's locked. Looks like it needs a key module. Okay, I'm in. Let's see what I can do with this. Water in my boots. Start blocking the drain. I wonder if I can get it out. Water level's going down. Should do it. Now I'm getting somewhere. Here we are. Another ornament. I should head back to Vegas and give this to Stemmer. An Osram crew. They don't look too good. Must be the ones that Tanakh's soldier mentioned. I should see if they're okay.
Never seen a storm like that in all my years.
I've been in tight spots before.
Can't get rid of the bomb. Locator shows there's another recording in there.
We're gonna get through this. I promise. Now go get some rest.
Do you need help?
Wish I could say we've been through worse. But I doubt any salvager has had this much bad luck on a single expedition.
Salvagers. You part of Karif's crew?
Yes. Didn't think we were that well known.
So you came here to make some armor. It doesn't look like things went according to plan.
You could say that again. I thought I had it made when we found some prime rollerback salvage out here. Then came the sandstorm, blew away most of our gear, and ran us right into a camp full of angry Tanakh. We fled, but by the time the storm died down, we found ourselves here with half our food gone, open to attack by machines and Tanakh alike.
Sounds like you could use a hand. I'm Aloy.
Runda. I can't ask you to help for free. How about I hire you to get us what we need? Draw up some contracts.
You don't have to.
Wouldn't be a proper salvager if I didn't. Won't take no for an answer.
You mentioned your people needed food.
We lost most of it when we ran away from the Tanakh. But only a bristleback would be able to sniff it out underneath all that sand.
That's not a bad idea. I'll look into it.
That's good to hear.
You mentioned this place is exposed to attack. Is there anything you can use to set up a perimeter?
We know there's a bellowback hanging around some ruins near here. Take it down without damaging its cargo sacks, and we could use it to make new traps. Set up a cordon. I'll make it a contract.
Sounds like a plan. You said you lost your gear?
Yes. Can't be sure where it is, since that storm gave us the runaround. But I have a general idea. It's all in the contract. If you can get that gear back, we'd at least be able to set up camp properly. Make the crew comfortable.
I'll take a look as soon as I can.
It's not much, but we have some salvage to trade. Good salvage is hard to come by, isn't it? Aloy, what can I do for you? That was a good trade.
If I never see Tanakh again, I'll count myself lucky.
I knew our luck would change eventually. Hey, Red.
I have to get going.
Good luck to us both.
I still can't believe those Tanakh soldiers try to come after us in the middle of a storm.
When I get a chance, I should read Runda's contracts. Take a look at the details. Russians might be around here. I need a pistol. Save the extra stock for later. It's detected something. Looks like it found something. Thanks for the help, buddy. Rations. Barely enough for a few people. I should check the other locations, see if I can find more. Those curves of metal must be the arches Abaddon mentioned. Well, they should be waiting for me there. Said some of their rations were lost around here. This bristleback should be able to dig out the containers. Just gotta get off, but tell me you got something. Good job, buddy. Let's see what we got. No rations. Still not enough for an entire crew. There might be more at the last location Rundon marked on the contract. Fire can help here. I'm gonna have to deal with those guys first. I was hoping to look for Rhonda's rations in this area. Can't do that without a bristleback, though.
I'm empty!
So you've a few moments left to live. Smash that machine! She's climbing! Don't lose her! Lost sight of them! They're in there! Shoot!
Thank you.
You want me to come after you? I'm coming for ya!
I think I got all of them. Should be safe to let that bristleback look for Runda's rations now. Let's see if we get lucky. Find something? Looks like someone was busy. Did you dig up some ration containers for me? Runda's rations should be around here. I need to find them. It looks like most of Runda's rations are here. I should take this back to her crew as soon as I can. Taking a closer look with my focus. There are traces of green shine on the cart. Maybe another Glinthawk flew off with the supply. My focus can track where the machine went. Osram. I didn't make it far. McClintock's on the top of that ruin. Might be salvage from the cart over there, too. Should be able to glide over to that ruin. Machine can tough out the cold. Frost won't help. At least I'll find a better use for this stuff than those Glintocks would.
Amazing elevating orb. Oh, see the world from spectacular heights.
I see you have a new orb ready to go. It looks, assembled.
Yes, as promised. It's a veteran of numerous test flights by yours truly. All successes, no interruptions in the air.
No issues at all? How did you do it?
A complete top-to-bottom reimagining of the orb with an eye toward the ultimate in comfort and reliable air travel. And a stronger tether. Two this time, you know, in case one breaks.
Smart.
And safe. Peace of mind is included with every ascent and descent. I guarantee. What do you say? Word got around about our last adventure. Having you go up with me again would... you know, encourage the more skittish in the crowd.
Just up and down? Okay, let's go.
Ladies and gentlemen, behold, as this fine, upstanding Nora and I take flight before your very eyes, let us ascend! Aloy, I swear you are my lucky charm. Oh, I've made a number of modifications to the orb. Reinforced joists. Ooh, double stitch fabric. Custom plating. Oh, and cushions. Great gears, Aloy. The world beneath us. It's so grand. City from up here, it's so vast. Imagine all the people who came here in its heyday. You know, it occurs to me I should have written a manual for flying this contraption. You know, we should have uniforms for flying. Something eye-catching, but tasteful. It'll be good for long airborne excursions, food and beverage service, and chairs. You would not believe the amount of work songs the Osram have about steam. I wonder if... No, there has to be a weight limit. Besides, how would you get the machine to stay still? Wow. You could really lose something if you dropped it from up here. Thirsty. So, how many kegs could this orb hold?
Take to the skies and see the world from a whole new perspective in my amazing, elevating orb. Improved for your comfort and safety.
Ah, Aloy! I can see by the look in your eye that you are ready to enjoy the orb once again. Ready to go?
Maybe later. I'm sure you'll have plenty of other customers soon.
Oh, yeah, no, I was hoping we would fly again, but... Hey, you're always welcome back, Aloy. Anytime.
That Bellowback Run dimension should be close by. I should look up a contract just to be sure. There you are. Rhonda needs that Bellowback taken down with its cargo sack intact. I'm gonna have to be careful. It's sloshing around in that Bellowback sack. Can't hit that. Rhonda needs the cargo sack intact.
Thank you.
Got it. I should let Rhonda know. Her people will want to salvage that cargo sack.